When I saw Perutz, he must have described who's round, or would have described Francis. But I remember very much John Kendrew, who just, you know, sensing that Francis and I might enjoy each other. So, you know, it was, and that happened with, you know, I can't imagine within 10 minutes we didn't know exactly. You know, that I had seen the X-ray photograph. Francis knew Maurice, you know, that we should learn more from Maurice right away, that, you know, you couldn't meet Francis for 2 minutes without learning, you know, the horrors of pulling him and beating them to the alpha helix, and that they, you know, the peptide bond had not been kept planar, and that, you know, Bragg was just... felt deeply humiliated that they had published the wrong structure for polypeptide chains. And that, you know, why not use this approach for DNA? So, you know, it was so simple that, you know, I'm sure at the end of the lunch, the only thing that mattered to me, when are we going to see Maurice, learn more details, so I'll start building a model. So it wasn't, I mean, it was, you know, we met Maurice, and then we learned that Rosalind had already been scheduled to give a seminar. I went to the seminar and then met Francis, who for some reason had arranged to go to Oxford. I think it was because he'd done the theory for the helical diffraction and wanted the pleasure of telling Dorothy Hodgkin what the theory was. So he was just going over to Bragg. And we'd met, somehow we must have met in Paddington Station. I think by then I had learned about the Society for Visiting Scientists. Which was on Old Burlington Street. And whether Bernal had started it, I'm sure he started with it. And, you know, for 10 and 6 or something like that, you got a bed and cornflakes for breakfast. No eggs, I remember, but you got cornflakes. And so I'm sure I spent the night in the Society for Visiting Scientists, which I think I became a member of. Met Francis, and then he started, you know, telling me how the helical theory would do it. So he was, you know, already keen, and because I had, you know, essentially told him DNA had no water because there was 4 residues for each symmetric unit, and he thought for the whole unit cell. So it was, you know, we didn't have to worry about water. It was just... what was the cation? And which led me to try and meet a couple people to see if we could measure some DNA to find out whether it was possibly magnesium or was it just sodium thymonucleate, as everyone had said it was, and there was no divalent ions. So... you know, whereas Linus just, you know, somehow assumed the hydrogens were there and you would form the hydrogen bond between using hydrogens attached to phosphate. So we built two different, superficially the same sort of structure, but, and we must have discussed the density. I'm sure we discussed things like density before Rosalind's seminar, you know. So that I was probably told by Francis what to try and find out. There was one standard textbook called Chemical Crystallography by a polymer chemist whose last name was Bunn, B-U-N-N, which I had begun to try and read as soon after I got to Cambridge. But which seemed to be totally indifferent to proteins or nucleic acids or any problems you might get involved. And for the first weeks in Cambridge, John Kendrew wanted to join me in his dilemma that he had been given crystals by the cytochrome chemist. It's in my book. The name doesn't come back to me. Who was in the Molteno Institute? His daughter. It somewhat crystallized horse myoglobin, and John had taken some pictures, and he was never able to repeat it. So we went out to the Cambridge slaughterhouse, just to the east. Forget the road, Mill Road or something, where there was a small, and where they had shot a horse that day. They were ex-race from Newmarket. And we got the heart out and purified it, and no crystals. So that happened within the first. So there were no crystals, you know, there was nothing, really nothing to do to help John. Yeah, I could have spent a year, you know, trying to crystallize, but that.
But now, had you got crystals, that could have changed your direction?
Could have, probably not.
It would have slowed you, perhaps, for a month.
I would have had something to do. As it was, I had nothing to do. And Max Perutz, I remember once marveling that I never seemed unhappy because I wasn't doing anything. Whereas he felt, in a sort of compulsive way, that every minute should be spent with some accomplishment.